Next part, we're going to World 2, Shady Show's Rest Home. This sounds so Patrick. Pretty much those ghost pirates are gonna give us trouble. So right now we're trying to find Mermaid Man. And we got a third remix of the music that was first heard in Battle for Bikini Bottom in the downtown levels and was in the movie game during the first world. I already told the controls about Patrick's moves, so there was no need for me to tell you guys again. This place has a lot of areas that will contain and he's baptized with stars all over the place. Oh, when you see these doors, you just hit the up button on the control pad. I don't really feel like going down. Oh, there's a ghost pirate. Just attack them with any attack and then they'll disappear. You'll know why the Flying Dutchman wants the Mermaid Man in due time. Sorry if this looks a little crooked. It's hard to get it all straight with a big stack. You can't actually see it, but I got a new stand on my television. Maybe sometime in the next video, since it will no doubt be short, I'll show what the stand is like. Whenever you see these areas, that means only SpongeBob can go through them since he's pretty much the shortest of all the group. Oh crap. This particular ghost pirate does make an appearance in the PC version of this game. I never played the PC version, but I've seen videos of it. It's just a point-and-click adventure. Just like the movie game and the Employee of the Month. The only SpongeBob games I used to have on PC is Battle for Bikini Bottom and the movie game. I never have this game, I never have Employee of the Month, I never have Operation Krabby Patty, and I never have Nighty Nightmare. Ooh, giant clam. It's a lot easier to get rid of enemies now that you have actual attacks and not just, you know, trying to jump on them. And I found Mermaid Man. Anyway, let's get on to World 2. with Sandy. He's sleep fine crying. Crime fighting. So we need to find a con signal to wake up Mermaid Man. Anyways, this is the first time we control Sandy. She punches. Her jump attack is using her lasso. And her running attack is like this. Now, I don't know what the creators were thinking on Sandy's sprite. I mean, look ahead. She doesn't have a tail. That's making her how she looks like in season 1. Because in season 1, while she was wearing her spacesuit, she doesn't have her tail showing. Until the show's got like a digital wink design in season 2, and they gave her a new design to have her tail show up. I thought it was pretty weird. But enough about Sandy's design. There are a lot of paths in this game. I can take you to different areas, but it will still take you to the same destination. Yeah. But they're not very long. So sometimes it will probably take me one video to complete it, or maybe two. I think I'm on an 8-minute mark by now. You can't really tell. Who knows? Maybe I can get this whole level in one video. If I don't mess around too much. Maybe I will. Sandy's got the motorcycle cop. That's one of our roles in the console version. It sure looks like it. I'm gonna continue on. Let's go with Squidward. Man Ray's back and he's stealing Mermaid Man's rings. It's another driving challenge, and only this time, instead of beating Man Ray, we're trying to destroy his Man Ray mobile. Oh crap. And we had to attack him before he gets away. And we have to watch out for those things, because it will make us slide on control, and I'm very bad at avoiding them. Hey. Just one more. Wherever you are. Ooh, a Krusty Krab minigame. I'll show that later. Right now, I'm gonna do the fourth level with SpongeBob. It's the same thing in the first one, only trickier. And a different soundtrack. You probably can't hear it, but it's the remix of the boss music in Revenge of a Flying Dutchman. Now, I don't want to talk through all this because I need to concentrate, because if I talk, then I'll lose concentration, so I'm going to just remain quiet for a little while because this is a lot trickier than the first one. See? Dang it. At least it's not on medium mode or I'll be feeling like crazy. But that ends this one. So next up will be Goo Lagoon, but first I gotta show you the Krusty Krab minigame. So pretty much ingredients will be falling. First you start with bottom bun, the patty, the cheese, the lettuce, the tomatoes, and then the top bun. They will come out random, so look really hard. In normal mode, if you got the wrong ingredient, you'll have to start over, which isn't fun. And this will be a thing in the levels themselves. So it's just like a little tutorial. And that will do for this video. And the next time it will be Goo Lagoon.